Good morning. I'm Lakshman Longar, lecturing in Electronics and Telecommunication Department from Government Polytechnic, Washim. Today we will see closed loop control systems. Like in a previous lecture, we have seen what is meant by open loop systems, what are the advantages and disadvantages of open loop control systems, and how they are beneficial for small applications. Means if there are less cost and maintenance is less, so at that point we can use open loop control system. But if you want to alter some output, or if you want to continuous, or if you want some automation, then we should go with closed loop control system. So here is a block diagram of closed loop control systems. You can see we are applying input to this summing point, that is and it is another input we are applying to summing point is feedback from feedback element. So it will produce error signal that error signal is given to the controller. Then controller is producing the whatever the controlling action they have to take. It will take the action and it will producing a controlling signal. It is passing to the actuator. Actually actuator is not shown over here, and actuator signal is passing to the plant or process and will produce the output, or plant or process will work accordingly. So so this is this block diagram keep in mind, because this ROPS, BOPS, these are the signals name, and you are using in this next lecture also. So ROPS is nothing but your reference input, or you can simply say input, and BOPS is your feedback. It is input coming from the feedback element. Here is a summing point. Again, here are two signs, like you can see plus sign and minus signs. Means it is depending, this plus sign minus sign I will explain later, but just keep in mind plus sign and minus sign indicates your positive and negative feedback. Which kind of feedback you are applying, this sign will mention here. Sign will mention. So it will producing error signal. That error signal is passing to this functional block. So this is a transfer function, that is GOPS is a transfer function, and it will produce the output signal, that is a COPS. Here you can see COPS is the output signal. Again, some part of COPS is applying to the feedback element, that is HOPS. See, there are some example of closed loop control system. This is a well known example, everyone knows. Like suppose you are traveling, or suppose you are driving car. So what is suppose we want to go from one destination to another destination. So at what speed and how, at which direction we know it, in which direction we need to move, or at what speed we need to travel, or you need to drive our car. So what is the input? Input is desired speed and direction. So we are applying to this summing point, and our controller. See, this is a brain is our controller. So controller will take an action, whether we need to increase accelerator, or whether we need to change gear system, or what action we need to take. So controller will that is brain will take an action, and according to actuator will work. Like hands legs are our actuator. Suppose we need to change gear, or suppose we need to increase our speed, so we need to press accelerator more, that therefore the speed will increase, and our hands will operate the wheel of that car. Then plant, so car is a plant, right? So accordingly car will work according on which gear it is in. So our car will work on that speed, or that particular speed. So car will move as per the speed mentioned by our mind, like second gear, third gear, or fourth gear. So the speed is our output, and the direction is also our output. Then what is the speed actually? Suppose car is moving or not, at what speed it is running, or on which direction the car is moving. So it will observe all this observed by our eyes. So our eyes, we can say our eyes is a feedback element, or it is nothing but a sensor to sense whether in which direction the car is moving, and at which gear the car is running on the road. So the our eyes will sense the what are the car operations will happen. That means the output will observe this sensor. That means our eyes, and our eyes will just giving the feedback to the again error system. Then error signal will produce according to what is suppose our speed. We want move car or we want to run car at 80 kilometer per hour. And if your car is running at 50 kilometer per hour, then our eyes will sense like it will see the meter. Here is a meter. So on meter, if car speed is 50, if you want 80, but your car speed is 50, then our eyes will sense that speed and it is given to the error signal. Error will produce the 30 kilometer, that is difference of 80 is the desire and 50 is right now. So it will produce error signal. It is given to the brain. The brain will give the command to our legs to increase the speed or to increase our accelerator so that the car speed will increase. Here is a very good example, I would say, to understand closed loop control system. So another examples you can there are many examples actually in closed loop control systems. So we can see also another example. So here are the other example, like first example is Sun Seeker solar system. Means Sun Seeker solar system, in this example, like input is your sunlight and plant is your solar panel. So as sun is moving from earth to west, then sun is moving, then our solar panel should also move towards the sun, and if sun is moving, the solar panel should follow the sunlight. So this is again solar tracking, Sun Seeker solar tracking system. So it will track the sunlight. So control is microcontroller and output is position change. The position should be changed according to the sunlight. So again, next example, we can have voltage stabilizer. In voltage stabilizer, what is output we want? Output which the suppose we are applying voltage stabilizer to the refrigerator, or voltage stabilizer, the output is again given to the suppose refrigerator, then what is the reference input or what is the output of particular refrigerator, we should know. So suppose there is spike in any spike, or there is low voltage in the coming from supply voltage, or suppose there is a large voltage, or suppose there is a one spike in between that that coming supply voltage, then it will adjust the whatever the or suppose there is some any fluctuation in the supply, so it will adjust and accordingly it will produce the output. So again, this is the again a very good example of voltage stabilizer. And everyone know that this is a missile launcher, means suppose guided missile. So in the guided missile, we know the target. So according to the target, we used to plan on which missile or the direction of the missile, how the direction of missile will be controlled. So your computer system will control the direction of the missile, and our input is the position and output is target. So on which target we should have to launch the missile, or we should have the which is what is the position of what should be the position of that missile, we can control by using this computer system. Then again, automatic toaster. In open loop system, we have seen like just a toaster, bare toaster, but here is automatic toaster. Means the difference is like in automatic toaster, it will sense? It will sense the moisture level. It will sense the moisture level we are applying. It will sense the what is the heating level, what is the temperature of that that particular toaster. If the temperature is increased in given temperature or given temperature range, then it will adjust automatically off. If the bread color is brown, then it will just automatically off the toaster. So we don't have to see whether the bread is brown, green, brown, gray or not. So this is a very good example again. So automatic electric iron. So everyone use this automatic iron. We know that suppose there are silky clothes, or suppose there are cotton clothes, so we can adjust accordingly whether you are using which clothes. So accordingly we can adjust the temperature. suppose temperature is iron temperature is greater than some specific temperature, then it will automatically off. If it is again cold, then it will automatically again on. So it is this example is very very well known about all of us. So these are the examples. So we'll see the next part. So in closed loop control system, we are using feedback. So therefore, from the feedback, we can control or what kind of work. That means automation is done. Actually, what kind of output we should have to produce. So we will know in the closed loop control system. So we'll see the advantages and disadvantages of the closed loop control system. See, here are the advantages. Highly accurate means due to the feedback, it is highly accurate. Second is high bandwidth, so the range of frequency is large. Facilitate automation. So we are using feedback. So this is very good advantage, I would say. So automation, it will give the feature of automation. We can automate our output, or we can change output. If output is altered by some disturbances or some noise, then we can alter or we can change our output or according to the desired one. So the next one is fast response. So fast response, why it is fast response? Because we are using again for feedback system. So we will come to the know what is the output is going on. We can alter the according to our requirement, less affected by the noise. So this is also a good advantage. Disadvantages are they are costlier. So there are number of components than open loop control system. Therefore, the obviously cost will increases, maintenance will increases, right? So as number of components will increase, therefore cost and maintenance will increases. Complicated to design. Obviously, if you are using multiple many component like feedback, it is a additional component we are using in closed loop control system. So therefore, complication will be increased as it is closed loop control system. So required more number of components. So this is all about the closed loop control system. In next lecture, we will see the difference of closed loop, open loop, closed loop system and open loop, closed loop system and open loop control system and closed loop control system. Thank you.